And welcome to another episode of Bite Size Yoga. My name is Emma Makepeace from A Tribe of Dreamers. And in this week's episode, I am speaking out to the ladies. So this one is to do with pelvic floor. For a lot of women, particularly after childbirth or as you get older, it can even be from things to do with endometriosis. You can start to suffer from pelvic floor problems, as well as prolapse issues, bladder, bowel issues, and recovery from surgery, whether it's from a laparoscopy, hysterectomy, or surgery for prolapse as well. So today I'm looking at a couple of practices that you can do for really looking after your body, because there are a lot of yoga poses that use quite intense abdominal muscle strength, and this can often have a negative effect on your reproductive organs and your lower organs, when especially if you are suffering from something such as a prolapse, because this can have an adverse effect where it starts to push down on those organs and actually cause you more harm than good, which is not what we want in yoga at all. We're all about honoring your body and where it's at. So today I want to show you a couple of really simple practices that you can do that support you to engage the pelvic floor muscles gently and begin to build some strength through there, and without using the abdominals to push down on those organs. So our first one is really simple. It's pranayama, our breathing practice. So coming into a comfortable seated position, and it's just being really conscious of your body when you breathe. So the position of your body, when you sit, your posture. So are you gently tucking the pelvic area up? Are you lifting up the belly button towards the spine, lifting up through the diaphragm? So we're creating space for the body to lift up, the internal organs to lift up, and lengthening out through the crown of the head. And as we breathe, just be aware of the sensations in your body coming from your root, so from your sitting bones, from your internal organs, and feeling the body as it breathes and lifts and lengthens, and as you exhale and relax as well, but maintaining that pelvic lift. So you can gently close down the eyes, and we'll just do four rounds of deep inhalation and exhalation. So as we inhale deeply now together through the nostrils, exhale completely through the nostrils. Inhale deeply. Exhale completely. Inhale deeply. Exhale completely. Inhale deeply. And exhale completely. Opening up the eyes. Just taking a moment to see how your body feels. You can continue doing that for as many rounds as you like. Just connecting into those feelings of the body, the internal organs, and being aware of the position of your body as you breathe, so that you're not slouching through the back, not hunching up through the shoulders, and not curved over, creating less space for our body as well. So the next one that we're coming into is cat and cow pose. So coming over onto your hands and knees. If you have any issues with the knees, you can always do folded up edge of your mat or folded up towel underneath to provide some space. Or if you have further things, then you can do this sitting as well. So just sitting comfortably on the edge of a chair is another great way to do this as a practice. So moving over, as you can tell, it's nice and chilly cold here, so I'm all rugged up. So we're on our hands and knees. Knees are underneath our hips, hands are underneath our shoulders. And draw, so you can see the difference here. As I draw my pelvic area up, my spine flattens out, and out through the crown of the head, through the back of the neck. As I inhale, relax the spine down, arching the gaze goes up. Exhale, reverse, take the spine up, draw the pelvic area under the chin to the chest. Inhale, into cow. Exhale, into cat. One more round, inhale, into cow. And exhale, into cat. Coming back to that neutral spine for our next posture, which is closely related. So we stay here for sunbird posture. So as we inhale, we lift up the left leg, extending behind us. Careful not to lift too high, so we're not opening up through the hip. We're keeping parallel to the floor. And you can just hold here. And exhale, lower down. Inhale, extend the opposite leg up. Draw the pelvic area up. And exhale, down. So this is a really gentle way to start. Just lifting the leg and drawing the pelvic area in. One more time. There are variations that you can add on to this depending on where your body is at. And this is something that you can chat to your health professional about, because it will depend on the severity of the symptoms that you have and what movements you can then do as well. But for our final posture, one of my favorite ways to finish a yoga class, I absolutely love it, is to come into a supported bridge pose. So grab a pillow and come and lie down on the mat, and we will move into this lovely gentle inversion that is perfect for allowing gravity to do the work for us. So just lying down comfortably. I'll try and wriggle back a bit so you can see me. Keep the knees bent, the feet are hip width apart, and we do bring the head onto the floor. Our pillow, lift up through the hips and place it underneath the lower back, the bottom, wherever is comfortable for you. And then just lower down the hips, just taking a moment to adjust. The hands can rest on the abdomen or out to the sides. And gently close down through the eyes. As we breathe deeply here, allow your spine to relax towards the floor, the back of the neck, the muscles of the face. And the pelvic area to gently tilt up so that gravity is taking over and allowing all of the internal organs to relax down into the abdominal space. A few more deep breaths here. When you're ready, pressing up through the heels, lift the hips and remove the pillow before rolling onto your side and coming back up. So there you have it. There are a couple of really simple ways that you can practice yoga in your life when you've got, and just really quick things that you can do to help build up those pelvic floor muscles if you find that they're really weak, or if you have prolapse issues or other issues with your bowel and bladder, you can incorporate some of these practices to just gently build up the muscles but without causing further problems. And as with anything medical, please always seek help from your GP or health practitioner, or if it's a physio or someone else as well, before taking on any new yoga poses or health exercises. So if you've enjoyed this episode today, please give it a thumbs up, and would love to hear how you find this. Let me know in the comments. And I look forward to seeing you all again next week for another episode of Bite Size Yoga.